Okay, hello everyone, and welcome to Tom Tech Academy. Today I want to share with you a presentation featuring our vendor neutral triplane strain analysis program, Auto Strain. I want to, of course, demonstrate for all of our attendees how quick, easy, reliable, and reproducible the results are, and in particular, how it can be utilized in the pediatric echo labs where the sector flip and other obstacles often present challenges. TomTech's Auto Strain program is, of course, vendor neutral, meaning that it is, of course, of no consequence where these images come from. So whether the images come from a Philips cart, GE cart, Siemens, or anywhere else, TomTech's triplane strain analysis software can be performed. AutoStrain provides fast and easy assessment of left ventricular volumes and function. By using the three apical views as a triplane analysis and or by selecting any of the three views, AutoStrain uses an automated contour speckle tracking technology to provide both volumetric data and the global longitudinal strain. By staying in your clinical workflow, no additional software is necessary and access to AutoStrain is instant. AutoStrain provides direct access to results such as the end-diastolic volume, the end-systolic volume, left ventricular ejection fraction, and the global longitudinal strain. All data that AutoStrain provides populates our worksheet and in many cases can also populate the report. The user may also perform editing at any time of the initial contours with instant updating to both the tracking and the results. Users also have access to both a bullseye plot and a segmental graphical data display. AutoStrain does also indeed account for the pediatric sector flip visualized in most pediatric echo labs. Once the desired study has been selected and all three of the apical views or any view wished to be analyzed has been pulled into the viewer, the user can begin the analysis. If the user wishes to include the aortic valve closure time, he or she must also select an appropriate spectral analysis clip as well. If multiple cardiac cycles have been acquired, as in most cases, the user will select the desired cycle of choice by referring to the reference markers located just right of the ECG. By using a left click and drag and drop, the reference markers can be set to define any one beat cardiac cycle. Complete this same process for all of the images to be analyzed. Next, to account for the sector flip observed in most pediatric echo labs, the user will refer to the sector orientation keys located to the left of the images. We will begin by flipping the apical four-chamber view. Next, we will do the same for the apical two and three-chamber views. However, for these views, we will not only flip up and down, but also left and right for proper segmental orientation. Once completed, we can proceed to the measurement package located in the upper right-hand corner. Select the left ventricle option and then select the strain three-plane option. Next, if desired, the aortic valve closure can be set. To perform this step, select the ABC option, bring your cursor into the Doppler image for left-click to initiate the start point, drag the cursor to the terminating point, and perform another left-click. Once this has been completed, select the automatic detection feature. To initiate the analysis, perform a left click in all or any of the selected apical views. Select play to visualize both the tracking and the calculated data that appears on the left side of the screen. Editing of the initial contour can be performed in any view. Simply select the desired image that requires editing with a left click, and do also note editing of any of the contours can be performed in both diastole and systole with instant updating to both the tracking and the data. In the lower right-hand corner, the user has access to a bullseye plot displaying both peak segmental and systolic strain and time to peak segmental analysis. The icon in the lower right-hand corner allows the user to toggle between both the bullseye and the segmental graphical display. The worksheet icon, located in the upper right-hand corner, allows the user to visualize all calculated data in a worksheet format. Saving and/or exporting options, such as the secondary capture feature, are available in the upper left-hand corner. This now concludes the recording segment of today's webinar. Please feel free to stay with us for an additional questions and answer session. Otherwise, thank you for attending, and I hope that this has provided some valuable information. For more information on any of our products, please visit www.tomtech.de. You may also at any time access additional courses at the TomTech Academy website. Thank you once again, and until next time, from everyone here at TomTech, have a fabulous day.